So in looking at the construction of the house, especially here, you can see the window casements, good example of the way this house was put together in a very sturdy fashion. The walls are over 3 feet thick, and they're done that way to help sustain the house, of course, against the weather and the elements, but also to support a second floor, which has a cantilevered balcony. But look at the way the window casements are flared out to let in the maximum amount of light. And probably originally there were no glass windows here, but only the wooden shutters to keep out the weather. And it was heated by a fireplace. Well, today you see an eclectic collection of furnishings that go all the way from the 1840s into the modern era, to the 1950s and beyond. And this is really the taste of the last occupant of this house, Mrs. Mayo Hayes O'Donnell. She and her husband, Bill, moved in 1941. And they collected from all over the world. Mrs. O'Donnell was kind of a local celebrity here. She was a writer for the local newspaper, and she had lots of friends in the art world who came to visit her. And many of the paintings you see in this room were gifts. One of my favorites is this volcano scene by Jules Tavernier. He was a person who specialized in painting Hawaiian volcanoes, especially at night. And another notable piece that you might find interesting, this one by Mary Evelyn McCormick. It's called Portrait of a Chinese Boy. It's a lovely watercolor, perfectly executed, and notable because this particular artist rarely painted portraits. She was mostly known for painting Monterey adobes. And if you look around the room, you also see Chinese furniture and pieces, like this Chinese trunk against the wall in the fireplace. Now, it sounds strange to say this today, but in the Mexican era, California's trade with China was actually less expensive and closer than it would have been to trade with the United States. Mexico did trade with Western Europe. Said, the only thing missing from the house that I can see is the sound of my aunt's typewriter clicking away in her office.